There are objects and shapes that are symmetrical, which means they are made up of exactly the same parts facing each other or rotated around an axis. This axis is called axis of symmetry, and it's possible that there is more than one in the same object. When we are drawing a symmetrical object, we do not need to necessarily draw the whole object. We can draw the first part and reflect the identical part to the other side, saving a lot of our time in the process. This particular tool is called mirror since it creates the mirror image of an object based on its axis of symmetry. To get a clearer idea of the way this tool can be used, two simple drawings have been created. As you can see in the first example, there are two simple polyline objects. However, those are only halves of the complete objects. Since the other half of each object is identical to the first one, I have created the axis of symmetry for each one separately. Now I'm going to use the mirror command to create the entire object. The mirror tool can be found in both the Modify menu and the Modify panel of the Home ribbon. As soon as the tool is active, a message prompts me to select the item I wish to mirror. I will select the first shape and then press Enter. Next, I need to specify the first point of the mirror axis. At this point, I should mention that to specify the first point of the axis, I need the endpoint snap active. So, with the endpoint active, I will click on the lower end of the line. Now, another message prompts me to specify the second point of the mirror line, so I will click on the other end of the line. Soon after I specified the mirror line, a message appears asking me if I wish the source objects to be erased. In this case, I don't want the initial polyline to be deleted, so I will select No to this message. Once I click No, notice that the polyline is mirrored and now two identical polylines are facing each other. The command deactivates automatically and the profile is now complete. I will activate the mirror tool again to create the reflection of the second object too. As soon as the command is active, I will select the second shape and press Enter. Then, I will specify the first point of the mirror axis by clicking on the upper end point of the line. To specify the second point of the mirror line, I will click on the other end of the line. Finally, in the message that appears asking me if I wish the source object to be erased, I will select No again. The command deactivates automatically, and this polyline is mirrored too. This profile is also complete. At that point, I should mention something very important. It is not necessary to draw the mirror axis in advance, and the reflected object doesn't have to intersect with the initial object. To understand more deeply what I'm saying, I will move on to the next example, where a single room's floor plan has been created. A table with a chair has been placed in this room, but in reality, this was meant to be a dining table with four chairs. In order to achieve that, I need to place two chairs in each side of the table symmetrically. Instead of drawing three more identical chairs, I'm going to mirror the one I have already created in such a way so there will be more than one chair next to the first one, and then two on the opposite side. To do so, I will activate the mirror command. Then, I will select all the parts of the chair and press Enter. At first, I will mirror the chair on the right side of the table. The mirror axis will be the imaginary line between the two midpoints of the table's length. As you have already understood, I need the midpoint snap active for this example. I will click on the midpoint of the upper side of the table to specify the first point of the mirror line, and then on the midpoint of the lower side to specify the second point of the mirror line. In the message that appears, I will select No. Now that the chairs are placed correctly in the upper side of the table, I will repeat the mirroring procedure to create the reflection of them in the lower side. I will activate the command, then I will select both the chairs, and I will press Enter. As for the mirror line, this time I will select the midpoint of the table's right side and then the midpoint of the table's left side. Of course, in the message that appears, I will select No because I want to keep all the chairs that were created. At last, the dining table has four chairs created in the quickest way possible.